We will take you to the
you
court.
Have, your
Mind
own
your
chief
word,
minister
what you
has
saying.
Visited the terrorist.
Please,
have, I am telling you, your chief minister
please,
from Goa.
We are not
Digvijay the
Singh who goes to Ajamgarh. We are not Digvijay Singh who goes and says that Osama bin Laden ji. We don't do all that. We don't call Batla House.
It's a fact.
We don't
it
call Batla House to be a
terrorist.
Okay, Alok of the JDU.
Criminalization of politics is known to one and all.
You know.
You have Ram Sena being
criminalization.
You have Chhabra being endorsed.
Do you believe? Do you believe?
What is the
reason?
Please, one second. One
Congress website. And there, see what all you have written about Narendra Modi.
Abid Rasool, why do you raise the question of Sabir Ali? 1 minute, please. Don't speak together. What Abid Rasool, just one person at a time, please. Think of the viewer. Abid Rasool, sorry, 1 minute. You raise Sabir Ali. Where does Sabir Ali come into this? Sabir Ali, by the way, dear viewers, is the JDU leader who joined the BJP, over whom there is a fight in the BJP. Yeah. Where does Sabir Ali come into this?
Let me complete. I have said that they are endorsing criminalization, they are endorsing communalism, they are endorsing terrorism. These are the things which I can prove on your channel how they are endorsing it. And when we are saying that we have condemned
go
it
ahead.
And we will
Mr.
take
Sam,
appropriate
please,
action,
Mr.
then you
Rasool,
put us into
go
a corner.
Ahead. And I will reply
have,
point by
have,
point to
they,
you.
They have
let the debate
criminal
honor, let the debate
they
be
have
between
a line
me
of
and him.
Speeches with them.
My question to JDU, please.
Yes,
one second. Ajay Alok of the JDU. Ajay Alok of the JDU, please. 1 minute, gentlemen. Ajay Alok of the JDU. I'd like Ajay Alok of the JDU. I'd like your comments. Ajay, I'd like your view. You're watching this. The one thing common between both the JDU and the Congress party is that you will reward anyone who takes on Narendra Modi. I would like to know from you your views on what this hate monger has said. Who is the Congress candidate from Saharanpur, and also your views on the issue of Sabir Ali, which suddenly came up in the course of the debate. Sabir Ali, after all, left your party to join the BJP. Abid Rasool raised that. I didn't. Ajay.
Let me thank you, Arnav. Let me thank you to get in the debate.
I'm sorry. Thank you.
Now, of course, what the Congress candidate has said, it's of course very condemnable. But you see, the using loud and foul language has been the order of the day for the last so many months we have been seeing, right from Congress and from BJP and from other parties also. Because it not only raises the screen value, it also raises the print value and raises the stock options in the opposition camp. Now, everybody on your panel was saying, why doesn't the Congress expel immediately
yeah.
and cancel the ticket and expel him out of the party? What happens next? Next day, you will find that the BJP will embrace him. This is the order of the day.
Now, what do you
any
mean?
Candidate using any person, you see what happened with Ram Vilas Paswan. Now you see today what happened with Sabir Ali.
What?
So it's nothing new.
What
anybody who uses foul language, he raises his stock options. And of course, it raises his stock option in the opposition camp. And BJP is very much eager to take these kind of elements into their party.
No, you're
so
bitter.
This thing will keep on happening. What Mr. Subramaniam Swamy said, is it correct? What Mr. Modi said recently, AK-47, AK-49 and AK-120, was that correct? So using foul language and arbitrary language and loud language has been the order of the day, and this will happen till the elections are over.
So why are you bitter about
Arnav,
your party? Are you bitter about your party leaders going and joining the BJP? Is that your bitterness speaking?
No, I'm not at all. I'm not at all bitter. There's a paucity in BJP. For the leader, so they are trying to import any kind of leader they are getting.
What do you mean any kind of leader? Till recent,
maybe Sabir Ali.
No, what's wrong with Sabir Ali? Till when he was with the JDU till last week, he was a good person.
What?
Now he's joined the BJP, so he's any kind of leader. Please explain. I don't understand what you're saying.
We expelled him. You try and understand the difference. Arnav, you try and understand the difference. We expelled him from the party. He didn't leave the party.
Why did you expel him from the party?
His actions very nefarious.
Why?
And what he was doing, it was not.
He was
expelled from the
party. Opponent, not on ideology.
He was expelled from the party because not only he praised the opponent, but he was spreading lies. He was given the ticket. He had taken the symbol and he was sitting in Delhi. And he was reporting that he's working in the field, which was not the case. So he was expelled. Because we don't have a dearth of leadership. There are at least 5 candidates in the running for the same constituency and much better than him. But since he was promised for a Lok Sabha ticket because he was denied a Rajya Sabha redomination, so he was offered a Lok Sabha.
No, I didn't raise the issue, Siddharth Singh, the JDU
so you,
has.
I wouldn't be surprised.
I didn't raise the issue.
If Congress expels him.
I didn't raise the issue the JDU has. Okay.
If Congress
no, one minute, one minute. The JDU has and the Congress party has. And the viewers of the News Hour tonight know that the biggest news story, which has inadvertently come through in the course of this debate, Siddharth, is the story of how the BJP vice president has gone and rebelled against the introduction of a person who he says is close to the founder of the Indian Mujahideen and has yet been garlanded and brought back into your party. Right. So I want to ask you this, therefore, because the issue has been raised, Siddharth, that what on earth is going on in your party? You need to answer to the Congress and the BJP. Are you desperate? Well, one day you bring in Pramod Muthalik.
He also tweeted.
What are you saying, Ajay?
Also tweeted, Arnav.
Yeah.
It's time for Dawood to enter BJP. Well, he also tweeted.
He said it's time for Dawood to enter the BJP. Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, the national vice president of the BJP, says it's time for Dawood Ibrahim also to join the BJP. I mean, if this is what he has tweeted, then all of us need an answer from you tonight, Siddharth. Your BJP vice president is saying this.
You just said that it is in the it's in the course of the debate this thing has come. So you are expecting that I should be aware. I'm learning from you because I have been on your channel.
Well, I'm glad to make you
45 minutes.
I am glad to let you know.
Since you have made me aware, I can only answer when I come out of this debate and know about the subject. But let me, and therefore, I am in no position to comment what my senior leader, who is very senior leader, that I can make a comment on that because you are raising a question. So I need to come out of the debate and make
a
comment.
Don't run away from the question. Don't. Do you doubt what we are saying?
We have shown.
Do you doubt what we are saying?
Our party is sensitive. You have seen in the case of Muthalik, if there is something wrong which has been done, they will be corrected. But I am in no position to give you a reply since I am in your debate.
No, one second. I think you should trust what all of us are telling you. And I think the news that we put out has some credibility. There is open rebellion in the BJP.
I'm not saying there is any credibility doubt. All I'm saying is, in the course of the debate, if you're going to tell me something which I'm not aware of, I need to come out. That much of leverage you will give to me that I must come out of the debate, comment about it. But I am in no position Shobha to comment whether it is right or wrong.
I'm sorry, so much of very precious TV time is being gobbled up on just waffling. So what is the point in these kind of denials? What people who are watching the show want to know, they want a few answers to some of the complicated issues that have been raised, which is why have we descended to these depths? What is political debate about? Is there any discourse left? There is no civility left. I can understand sparring. I can understand people taking on their rivals. There was a time when there was a culture of debate which people would look forward to, that you could hammer your rivals and do it with intelligence, wit and an educated background. I think what we are seeing today is a sort of jungly tutu meme behavior, which even C-grade Bollywood dialogue writers would be ashamed of. And this coming from a class, some of the completely uneducated, illiterate thugs in politics, yes, one expects that. But this coming from a class of calling themselves Oxbridge scholars and otherwise.
Salman Khurshid, you forgot what he said? Salman Khurshid said, I have worked with the pen, I will work with blood
exactly.
now.
Exactly. And then we have Meenakshi Lekha, if someone calls someone a cockroach, someone says someone is a frog, someone else talks about AK-49. I mean, every single party, there's no exception. So it shows a complete lack of education and a complete lack of any kind of civility left in political discourse.
Yes, Mr. Raghunandan.
That is a pity.
Mr. Raghunandan.
Yeah, Arnab, that's precisely the point. It's exactly what Shobha has said. You see, the point is that there's a culture of impunity now. There is a very strong law. There's a section 125 of the People's Representation Act is very, very strong, but it's not been implemented. And as long as the administration is soft and doesn't act upon some of these cases, people are going to act with impunity. So what we really need now at this juncture is for this election commission to come into the picture. We must remember that every person who works during an election does not work under the state administration. He or she works under the control and superintendence of the Central Election Commission. So it should be the Central Election Commission that should direct a case to be filed, arrest the man, and not only arrest this man, but arrest other people in other parties without any fear of favor, and take action.
I think the Chief Election Commission, everyone really needs drastic remedy. No, I think
we are all looking at the Election Commission.
And
people will lower the bar even further.
No, we are all looking at the Election Commission. We have a lot of faith in the Election Commission. The Election Commission, when people go and say that put restraints on the media, etc., Election Commission is very quick to meet political parties and take action. When they want to ban opinion polls, Election Commission is very busy, meets them immediately and takes action. I'm challenging and asking the Election Commission tonight that here is an opportunity for the Election Commission to prove that it believes in its own model code of conduct, because Mr. Chief Election Commissioner, your model code of conduct says no party or candidate can indulge in any activity which may aggravate or create mutual hatred between caste, communities, religious or linguistic. This is a classical example of the violation of the model code of conduct, and this man has to be thrown out. Now, Mr. Rasool, before he's thrown out, will you throw him out yourself? Will you throw him out or will you wait for him to be thrown out?
BJP will embrace him.
Yes, Ajay.
And I have told you time and again that the party will take
a call. If the Congress throws him out, the BJP will embrace him the next day. Mark my words.
That would be appropriate, and that would be in line with the ideology of the Congress. You don't need to worry on that issue.
No, we are worried.
The second part is when you are trying to put Congress into a corner, you need to give equal importance to the statements and hate speeches done by the BJP leaders.
No, there is nothing.
Subramaniam Swamy. Subramaniam Swamy was not a candidate in an election and said something like that,
then we would have asked him. But no, please
even
don't.
If he is not a candidate, he is a spokesperson of that party. When he is a spokesperson,
so
of
you
the
are
party
therefore saying
that language.
No, no.
It
so,
needs
so, so your argument.
The highest levels.
So your argument is we will descend to the lowest depth possible.
Absolutely.
We will descend to the lowest depths possible because we believe...
We will stand by the ideology of a party. We will stand by the
ideology. I need to go into a break. And you are just planning something which has not happened now. I give Gaurav Bhatia the last word. Ashok Pandit, I'm closing in. Gaurav Bhatia has the last word. Gaurav Bhatia has the last word.
Arnab, I think this is the chance for Election Commission of India also to redeem itself and to show that it's not a toothless body. In the past, we have seen that they have done nothing but to reprimand, and I think that's not enough.
And
they have all the power under the Constitution, as mentioned by the panelists, and they should take stern action against
and
that
this
person.
This is the challenge for you. To call Akhilesh right now and say, don't be stuck to the dirty glue of vote bank politics. Take action against this man or your own, whatever the risks to your vote banks may be. Gaurav Bhatia and to everyone else, thank you very much.